Hi there, friends. This is Emily Craig on my channel, and I'm trying to show something here. The difference between participating and dominating, right? In a participating or cooperative modality, we can allow our culture to dovetail in and among other cultures. But in a dominating culture, it's all or nothing. And I've been experienced with and had the difficulty involved in this all or nothing mentality that comes with certain cultures, all right? Certain cultures are all or nothing. They're the isms, okay? The isms we hear about, socialism, communism, Islamism, Zionism, are the isms where the ism dominates and there's no room for anything else. There are also the other cultures who permit dovetailing, where my culture can interact with your culture and there's no harm. I'm going to play for you a dance that's done by Danish and Norwegian peoples in the Faroe Islands that shows you the real tenacity of their culture in the face of very hard and difficult weather. Their weather is killer up there, okay? And I want you to think about how the belief that we have to dominate over our environment creates a situation where there's no room for anybody else. And this is the problem we have with globalism and the New World Order. Because in the New World Order, there is one set of laws without rights. We're just all consumable objects, where there's no room for other. Look at this, just for me.
Hasa de at kalla til søynar menn tas vurmuş konkurel ahetler avrundu doyme eskalar melanka terka amata kosta doyme kimurdan sargat dan slayring glay roya vor spendil parting gu yamlar esnetler avrayo potka kadr skarla grey kudde vitsche var melanka presje etoy dey kimurdan sargat dan
Okay, you've seen enough of this. All right, you've seen enough. This is in the Faroe Islands in the North Atlantic. Now, it might as well be Hawaiians in the Hawaiian Islands or the South Sea Islands or the Inuit up in Greenland or the people on the Sahara. These are people who live at the edge of survival. And the European Union and the New World Order want to tell them what they're going to have to do, which is going to drive them out of the ability to survive. The European Union and the United Nations Agenda 2030 is here to tell people what they have to do to survive. And if they don't survive, that that helps. That's what the European Union and the United Nations want, is for people to die. Can you understand how wacko crazy this is? The God of this world did not intend for one culture to desecrate, decimate, and destroy other cultures. In fact, if you remember Star Trek, there was a prime directive that says, don't mess with cultures. One culture does not mess with another culture. But the European Union and the New World Order have not learned that yet. They're still telling us they're going to mess with our culture and our way of living, and they're going to impose upon us their scientistic, secular, materialist beliefs and doctrines and dogmas about what is true and what's real, okay? Stuff like, okay, the sun's 93 million miles away, the moon's 226,000 miles away. Okay, this bullshit. The world is a spinning ball with all the water spraying off the bottom. Okay, these scientific specialists want to believe that they're going to control how we think and how our culture survives. And I'm here to tell you that the Celtic culture has great value and is worth survival. And I'm here to agree with that England, Ireland, Scotland, and Wales in the British Isles had a Celtic culture that went for 1,000 years in peace. And the European Union and the United Nations Agenda 2030 are here to destroy the culture that could exist in peace for 1,000 years. And I'm here to say to those puffed up elitist gazillionaires and oligarchs, no. Your way of hoarding wealth, your way of keeping everything to yourself, is not how humanity will survive into the future. That's my statement to Mark Zuckerberg and Jeff Bezos and Jack, what's his name? Okay. These high-tech people, gazillionaires, who hoard the assets to keep away from everybody else. You high-tech people don't understand that culture is more important than your preferences. So lay off. We, the people of this world, have a right to our lives.